Before you even scroll off, you know GCC, but let me show you how they're going to change the custom market forever. GCC obviously dominates the pad-printed custom market, which is certainly a niche, but it's a big one nonetheless. While GCC has been cooking up some of their best clones, they've also been hard at work on some pad-printed arms for their alternate custom figures as well. The Preggers Padme that GCC created here is outstanding. A direct rip from the Skywalker Saga with an alternate pad-printed face with all official parts. Note the dual-molded legs here, the incredible print on them, and the highlight here, the immaculate arm printing. Custom pad printing for arms like this coming to the market can truly shake things up. The limited Padme figures that LEGO has even produced leaves tons of room for customs. So I asked my friend Dwin here to cover some of GCC's history with the Senator.
Alright, so this is the official Episode 2 Geonosis Arena Padme, and it is one of the only movie Padme figure that we've gotten from LEGO, while Princess Leia gets like 5 trillion variants. I love this figure, but it gets a bit too pricey, and I wanted to get the non-scratched version of the torso to make the figure look more cleaner. Well, GCC Like a Go came out of nowhere and made this replica of the Episode 2 Padme torso, but without the damage and the scratch, which is just unbelievable. It has the same printing as LEGO, printed on official pieces, and I seriously don't know how they managed to get this design this close, probably magic. But this makes the figure looks way cleaner and proper than the damaged one.
But it doesn't just end with Padme. GCC also did this with Sky Guy, or custom Clone Wars appropriate outfit for Anakin. The official dual molded parts, pad printing, insane arm print is just jaw dropping. With GCC selling these arms for $5 on the side, this is the direction that changes the custom game forever. Like, check out these custom clone cadets that GCC also made. These are straight from the game and these look incredible. I added dual molded legs and hairs to complete all the figures lined up. Also, here's some hair pieces I tested. Still figuring it out. I imagine a future where GCC provides pad printed alternatives for more figures, just like the pad printed dual molded legs for the jump troopers. These are game changers. I felt the same way when printed capes hit the market. It feels like a shift in the custom world, making every figure UCS quality is exactly what we want to see. I love to eventually shift away from decal than UV printed arms, which to me feels like the only alternative on the market today. Pad printing on official parts is just that good. The customer will pay extra for official parts with the OEM process that looks this good. I'm ready to see more game changers like pad printed arms. That's it.